Bonjour, je m'appelle Tom et j'apprends français pour une semaine. And apologies to any French people who will watch this because I have just destroyed your language. So I've been in Paris for just 1 week now and I'm loving it so far. The classes have been really, really good. The tuition is 100% in French at the school I'm going to. So literally no English from day one, And the idea is you kind of just like pick it up from context or whatever. But literally on day one, the teacher comes in and is like, French, 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 French. And I can tell that she's saying, oh, everybody here speaks okay French, so we're just gonna speak French now. And I put my hand up and said, no, I don't speak French. And she goes, well, obviously you do, or at least you can understand it because I've just been speaking in French and you knew to object at that point. So I kind of stuffed myself there a little bit. But we've been covering so much stuff in class so far. Like already we've done to have and to be, we've done regular conjugation, we've done questions, likes, dislikes, and then we just started to go and to make the verbs. So much stuff, and like it's all kind of getting into my brain sort of very, very slowly, but I can feel it all going in. However, there are some things that are upsetting me. At the moment, my pronunciation is awful, absolutely awful. I'm really used to German where you just say every single letter and it's really clear how it's pronounced, and in French it is just completely ridiculous. Sometimes you say the whole word, sometimes you don't, sometimes you stop halfway, sometimes you really emphasize the end, and sometimes it's just completely irrelevant. I can't see any sort of like system or context to it. Here's a good example. So we were doing questions, and the question what? So there's these four forms, each of which has an important grammatical difference. But all four of them, when you're speaking, is just quel. Quel, 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 quel. Even though they're spelled quite differently, they have different endings, and in written, it would be like really silly to do it in a different way. But pronunciation has nothing on the numbers, because the number system is just batshit crazy. So 1 to 10 is kind of like English, and then you have 12, 13, 14, and you have this like teen, you know, the number, and then a thing at the end. But then when you get to 17, just arbitrarily, you say 7, 10, 8, 10, 9, 10. But fine, okay, so far so strange. But then when you get to 60, you sort of start counting all over again, because you do 61, 62, but when you get to 70, you say 60, 10, and then 60, 11, 60, 12, which is ridiculous. But then when you get to 80, you start that all over again, and you count from 80. But now you're not saying 80, you're saying 420s. So you have to say 80, which is 81. And one of my friends on the course pointed out that to say 97, you have to use four different words and mention four different numbers. Why? Why? Pourquoi? So pronunciation and numbers are my two like pet peeves at the moment, but other than that, it's going so well. I'm really loving it. Because I started from absolute scratch, I feel like I'm making huge jumps every day, which is equal parts really fun and I love it, but also incredibly stressful, you know, because there's just so much information that needs to go into my head every day. So, really loving the language, but the city as well is so cool. Paris is great. I mean, it's exactly as you'd expect, really. It's beautiful, the food is incredible, the bread and the cheese in particular, very good. And there's so much to do, so many beautiful things to go and see, different museums, galleries. We've barely even scratched the surface, and every afternoon after school we've been going and doing stuff. Something else, actually, is that we found it's very easy to stay out really late, because the Parisians eat really late, everything's open. You know, when we went to Sacré-Cœur, we sat there, we had a beer, we watched the sun go down, and then suddenly we realized it was 10 o'clock and we hadn't had any dinner. So we go back down to Montmartre, go in, find a cafe, sit there, have a drink, and then before we know it, it's coming up to like 1 in the morning and we all end up missing our metros and we have to like take taxis back and everything, and the city and the streets are just still so busy and there's so much life, even at like 1 in the morning, you don't even realize that it's like going home time. So needless to say, as well as learning, we've also been doing loads of stuff as well. Like my course mates are great, like I've made some really nice friends already. Everybody's super cool. All Saturday, we were wandering around the canal.
This is Anna.
Hey Anna.
This is Cassie.
Bonjour.
This is Zach.
Hello.
Bonjour.
Hi.
We met at République Metro. I'm gonna try and say these things in a Frenchy way, by the way. If I sound absurd, just, you know, let me know in the comments. And then we walked up Canal Saint-Martin and stopping off along the way at cafes, getting like a glass of wine or something, sitting in the sunshine.
What an awful, awful day.
How you doing there, Zach?
I'm not mad about this.
You're not mad about that? Having a good time?
Then we got to the top and there were all these kids jumping in the canal off this bridge. And all these kids come running up to me And they're like, oh, you're a journalist. What is this for? And I was like, oh, it's for YouTube. They're like, how many subscribers have you got? Immediately they wanted to know. And I said, oh, about 300. And they were like, 3000? And I was like, no, not 3,000, 300. But that seemed to be, they were still happy with 300. So they immediately ran off and like made me promise that I would film them. We were slowly like convincing ourselves that we should go and do it as well. And in the end, me, Zach and Anna all went and jump off this thing, and it was really great. So before I go, I had a guy on Reddit tell me that I should start using as much French as possible in these videos so that I can like track and see my progress over time, which is an excellent idea. At the moment, a week in, I really feel like I can barely say my name. So although I'm enjoying throwing out the occasional word, I'm going to leave that until week two, and then I promise I will start throwing in as much French as I can into these things. Apart from that though, please let me know in the comments if there's anything in particular you think I should cover or talk about in these vlogs. Any tips you might have would also definitely be appreciated. I would love that, especially on pronunciation. If you can find anything helpful for pronunciation, that would be great. Until next time though, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon. Au revoir.